Everybody, happy Wednesday. It is I, your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend, Joe Seavey. And happy Wednesday, guys. And Wednesday, of course, is part of our creative writing class that we like to call ghostwriting. Ghostwriting is when we take a popular song that's in the Billboard Top 100, and we take the chorus, and we write our own original lyrics in place of the lyrics from the original artist lyrics, okay? Why do we do this? Well, it's a great exercise to keep your chops in shape and to, you know, try to compete with the real song as far as creativity, making it rhyme, making great story, writing great lyrics. It's to showcase your chops to a song that you all already know works, is a certified hit song. And you're taking the words, pulling them out, using the same exact melody, but putting your own original lyrics in place of the lyrics that are already there. I love doing this exercise. It's almost like, you know what parodies are, a song parody, like, you know, Weird Al Yankovic did Eat It instead of Beat It from Michael Jackson. Those kind of songs. But this, we're not trying to be funny. We're trying to write something as creative as the original song. And, you know, it can be the same subject matter as the song really is. Or you can write whatever you want. There's no rules. The only rules is, or try to, if there's... Like if the song that we're emulating has like three syllable words, try to come up with a three syllable word. If the song has a bunch of one syllable words, try to write that as well. But that's really not the main thing. The most important part is that every bounce of their words, you have to stop and start when they stop and start. So the minute they start singing, you should start singing. Every word should be in place. Your word should be, you know, replacing the original ones. But there can't be more syllables than's really there. Do you know what I'm saying? Now, if they have a three-syllable word and you have three one-syllable words, as long as it fits in the pattern and you can sing it to sound legit, then that's fine. Okay? That's the only rule. It has to rhyme. It has to tell a story. But it also has to... start when they start and stop when they stop. Okay. So the song that we're looking at tonight as our, you know, exercise song is Maroon 5's. The song is called Beautiful Mistakes. Really pretty song. It's Maroon 5 and it's Megan Thee Stallion who's doing the rap part. So it's, or, and she's singing too, actually. She's singing in this, there's a second part that she sings, and then in the bridge, she does a rap. But, you know, again, I say this every week, and it's really the truth. This is not an easy exercise. You have to really focus. You have to really concentrate. Listen to the original song. This is like, this. I'm going to prep you guys in the way that you should approach this exercise, is that you should really carefully listen to the song, especially the lyric video. You know, there's lyric videos for every song now on YouTube. All you have to do is type in the name of the song and then afterwards write the word lyrics, and there'll be a million lyric videos that pop up of the song with the lyrics that pop up, okay? So what you should do is go to the chorus of the song. That's the part that's always the same. You know what a chorus is. You go to the chorus, and you listen to the chorus, then pause it. Grab your pen and paper, like that, okay? Now, what I did was, and I show you this every week, and I'm going to continue because it's the greatest way to see where you're going. You see, it says theirs, beautiful mistake. So what I did was I lined it up by the syllables. Beautiful is three syllables. Mistake is two. Okay. Beautiful mistake. So the first word is three syllables. Second word is two. Okay. What I wrote was never will forget. Never will forget. Beautiful mistake. See what I did there? And then that's their next line. And then my line is right under it and so forth. And I put like dashes between each word and between the syllables so I know exactly where I'm at in the song. So I hope you guys can see that, okay? So that is the way I do it, okay? And it's really easy. And then it shows you how much more you have to write, you know? So first, what I want you to do is I want you to listen to their song. And I want you to listen to the chorus maybe five or six times. Just when the chorus is done, go back. On the video I watched, their chorus starts at about, let me see. Their chorus starts at about, I think it's, I think it's about 37 seconds or 38 seconds, and then the song starts. Okay, so that way you know where you are in the song. Yeah, it starts at 38 seconds. So 38 seconds is where their chorus starts. And it says, beautiful mistakes. You'll see it. I make inside my head. She's naked in my bed. You know, you'll read it there. Sit down and really, really listen to that chorus and look at the words that pop up. Okay? What this, the chorus ends at about 10. Okay? Go back to 38 seconds. Listen to it again. Write it down. Then leave a space for yours. See? And then write. So you write theirs. Skip. Write the second one, skip, write the third line, skip, you know, and so on. And then you leave that space for your lyrics. And then that way you'll have it, you know, and you'll be able to compare. And it really forces you to be creative in a very short amount of time. It's not like you can meander. They're going straight into a story. You got to go straight into a story. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to play you I'm going to play you their chorus, okay? So, without further ado, this is Maroon 5's chorus, Beautiful Mistakes. So here it is.
Beautiful mistakes I make inside my head. She's naked in my bed. And now we lie awake, making beautiful mistakes.
That's their chorus. So I really want you to really listen again. I want you to start writing ideas down. Doesn't have to be like theirs. It can be the similar vein, but you can't use any of their words. You cannot use any of their words. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to read you my words. So now that you heard their words, right? Never will forget the first time that we met. I lit your cigarette. We talked until the day, taking all my fears away. I'll never let you go. You know I love you so. I don't have no regrets about the first time that we met. Oh, 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 no regrets. Oh, 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 no regrets. Oh, 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 no. About the first time that we met. So that's mine. So what I'm going to do right now is I found a karaoke version of this and I did a performance of it. So here it is.
Mm-hmm.
Never will forget the first time that we met. I lit your cigarette. We talk until the day, taking all my fears away. I'll never let you go. You know I love you so. I don't have no regrets about the first time that we met. Oh, no regrets. Oh, no regrets. Oh, no. About the first time that we met. And that's the whole chorus, you guys. All right, guys, I can't wait to see what you wrote for those lyrics in place of the original ones. All right, guys, that is all the time that we have for tonight. This is your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend Joe Seeby signing off. I love you guys. I will see you. Have a wonderful night, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace.